unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given.
And the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned.
The wolf will lie down with the lamb, the leopard will lie down with the goat, the calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a little child will lead them.
Salvation is created, and the world is forever changed because God has touched it with his gift of love and grace.
We have come together to celebrate God's gift of hope, of joy, and of peace.
Set us free.
Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel, God with us.
Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the descendants of David, and the virgin's name was Mary.
Greetings, favored one. The Lord is with you. Do not be afraid, for you have found favor with God. You will conceive and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus, and his kingdom will have no end.
How can this be?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. And for that reason, the Holy Child shall be called the Son of God.
With God, nothing is impossible.
Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. Things weren't easy at first for Mary when she told Joseph of the angel's words to her.
Joseph was puzzled and upset. All of his future dreams with the life with Mary were instantly shattered to the customs of the time. An announcement of joy became a source of hurt and confusion.
But as always, God was in complete control and would use the confusion and hurt to pave the way to a triumphant fulfillment of his plan.
By trusting God, Mary and Joseph moved ahead through the pain. When Caesar's tax decree had been declared, they soon made their way to Bethlehem.
The road was crowded with many families, each on the way to an ancestral city. It was almost time for Mary to deliver her child.
But you, Bethlehem, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be the ruler over Israel.
The road was long and dirty, but when Mary and Joseph finally saw the lights of Bethlehem, they rejoiced at the sight of the small town.
Can the Christ Child bring peace to our lives. Had heard the prophecies of a Messiah for a long time, but they were not ready for the spectacle that would suddenly appear before them out of nowhere.
It was as if the entire sky opened up, and it was instantly filled with laughing, singing, and joyful angels.
And the shepherds were naturally deathly afraid, but God's peace would soon replace their fright. The angels brought them the message of the ages in two simple yet profound words.
Mary held the hope of the world in her arms. Could she or he
Thank you.
were initially troubled, but eventually found peace. Shepherds on a hillside were trembling with fear, but were told to fear not. It was only God who brought them true peace through the advent of his Son.
The world promises peace, but always fails to deliver real, abiding peace.
Most people's pursuit of peace is only an attempt to get away from problems. Apart from God, there is no real peace in this world.
Jesus is the incarnation of God's ultimate peace offering to the world. Peace has come.
Peace has come!
Whatever our life circumstances yesterday, today, or tomorrow, we rejoice in the truth of your light and that you sent your Son to change the world and us forever.